video we'll be discussing how to decode histion examination of a respiratory case. So we have with us a 40-year-old male who presented with chief complaints of fever with chill since 3 days, productive cough since 2 days, and shortness of breath since 2 days. So the patient was apparently well 3 days back when he had fever, which was undocumented and associated with chills, and the patient has daily spikes of fever present, which was relieved for some time by medication. Also, the patient has productive cough since 2 days, having rusty brown color, and the sputum is non-foul smelling, and the amount of sputum doesn't vary with posture. Next, the shortness of breath was preceded by cough and is more on the lying on left side, and there is no association with paroxysmal nocturnal dyspnea and orthopnea, and there is no previous history of such shortness of breath. Also, there is no history of odynophagia, sore throat, hoarseness, stridor or wheeze, and there is no history of preceding coryza present. Also, there is no history of bluish discoloration of skin and eye, and there is no history of altered sensorium. On personal history, the patient is a chronic alcohol and smoker. On examination, the general physical examination, the pallor is present, whereas there is no icterus, cyanosis, clubbing, lymphadenopathy or edema, and there is no conjunctival injection or reddening, and there is no TB stigmata present. On respiratory examination, on inspection, nasal flaring is present, use of accessory muscles is present, trachea lies in midline, the chest movements are decreased on the right side, the apex impulse is at normal location, that is in the 5th intercostal space just middle to the midclavicular line, whereas on palpation, again the trachea is in midline, the diameters are normal, the expansion is decreased on the right side, vocal femitis is increased in the right infraaxillary and the subscapular areas, and there is a woody dull knot present in the right infraaxillary and subscapular area on percussion, whereas on auscultation, bronchial bed sounds are present with increased vocal resonance in the right infraaxillary and subscapular areas with positive whispering pectoral leaky and egophony. So this is the case, and now we'll be discussing how to decode the history and examination. So we have a 40-year-old male with complaints of fever, productive cough and shortness of breath. So as the patient has fever with productive cough with shortness of breath, on the first look it looks like to be a infected airway disorder. Okay, as in case of either pleural disorder or in case of an interstitial disorder, the cough might be present but it will be dry. So on the first look it looks like a infected airway disorder, and we should know what can be the differentials. The differentials can be pharyngitis, laryngitis, bronchitis, or involving the alveoli, that is it can be pneumonia, can be lung abscess, can be bronchiectasis, or it can be an acute exacerbation of COPD. So these all can be the differentials based on the chief complaint. So our HOPI should be such that we can localize any one of this cause. So there is fever present associated with chills and the daily spikes are present. As the chills are present, this is probably a high grade fever. Okay, so the first positive finding that we've got is this is a high grade fever. The next one is there is productive cough present, which we have already discussed is suggestive of an airway disorder. Now the productive cough is of characteristic rusty brown type, which is usually present in a streptococcal pneumonia. Okay, so one positive finding is rusty brown sputum. Also, the cough that is present is the sputum that is present is non-foul smelling. So this is also an important history, as in case of lung abscess and bronchiectasis, usually a foul smelling sputum is present. Also, there is no association with posture. In cases of lung abscess, there will be more cough production if the lung with the abscess is lying on the upward side, as in that position there will be more drainage of the pus. Okay, but in this case neither there is any relation with the posture, neither it is non-foul smelling. Also, shortness of breath is preceded by cough, and it is more on the lying on the left side. As the shortness of breath is preceded by cough, and also there is no PND and orthopnea, this is less likely due to a CVS and more likely due to a respi case. So we have localized that probably the shortness of breath here is due to respicase, and as the shortness of breath is more on lying on the left side and we are suspecting a airway disorder, so probably there is a right-sided pathology and there is no previous history of such shortness of breath or such cough. In cases of bronchiectasis or acute exacerbation of COPD, the patient would have had similar episodes in the past, and also there would have been a constant shortness of breath present, which would have now been exacerbated, but there is no such history present. Also, there is no history of odynophagia, sore throat, hoarseness, stridor or wheeze. Okay, so based on HOPI, we have probably ruled out pharyngitis, as there is no odynophagia or sore throat present. As no hoarseness or stridor is present, the laryngitis or croup is less likely. Bronchitis may be present. There is no audible wheeze on bare ear. So bronchitis is less likely, but it should still be kept as a differential, as we might get a wheeze on auscultation. Similarly, lung abscess and bronchiectasis are less likely differential here, because there is no foul smelling discharge, there is no history of previous there is no history of change on posture, and there is no history of previous shortness of breath episodes. Also, it is less likely to have exacerbation of COPD, because there is no history of previous shortness of breath or previous such attacks. So based on history, there are two main differentials. One is the bronchitis and another is the pneumonia. Okay, also there is no history of preceding coryza present, as we have now known that probably the cause is either pneumonia or the bronchitis. We should look for the organism, which by the rusty sputum suggests more of streptococcal pneumonia, and also as there is no previous upper respiratory tract infection present, it is less likely to be staph aureus. Also, there is no history of bluish discoloration of skin, and there is no history of altered sensorium, which are features of type 1 respiratory failure, which can occur in cases of pneumonia. So also on history, the patient is a chronic alcohol and smoker, which are important risk factors for pneumonia due to streptococcus. So based on history, we have two differentials. One is the bronchitis and one is pneumonia. On general physical examination, pallor is present, which might have been present in this case due to chronic alcoholism, which might have led to the poor nutrition. The icterus, cyanosis, clubbing, lymphadenopathy and edema is absent, but these are very important to be checked in a case of respiratory case, as icterus can be present either due to a cor pulmonale, or it may be due to ATT induced hepatotoxicity in a case of pulmonary TB. Looking for cyanosis is very important, as in cases of severe respiratory diseases, the cyanosis might have been present. Also, the clubbing is also an important finding to look for in case of respiratory case, as in case of lung abscess and bronchiectasis, clubbing can be present, whereas in case of COPD or tuberculosis, the clubbing is absent. Also, lymphadenopathy may be present in a tuberculosis case, whereas edema due to a respiratory cause can be either due to bronchiectasis, where increased sputum coming out through the mouth leads to hyperproteinemia, leading to the edema. Also, due to cor pulmonale, there can be edema present, whereas also due to type 2 respiratory failure, the pedal edema can occur. Also, there is no conjunctival injection, which can be present in a type 2 respiratory failure, and also there are no other findings of TB stigmata. On respiratory examination, there is nasal flaring and use of accessory muscles present, which suggests the patient is currently in distress. The trachea is in midline, which suggests either it is a pathology within the lung, or there might be a pathology within the pleural cavity, but it is not enough to push the trachea. Similarly, the chest apex impulse is at normal location, which also suggests that either there is a mild pleural cavity pathology or there is a pathology within the lung. Now the chest movements are decreased on the right side, which suggests that probably this is a right-sided pathology. On palpation, the diameters are normal, which suggests that this is probably acute pathology and not a chronic one. And expansion is decreased on the right side, which again suggests that this is a right-sided pathology. Now the vocal femitis is increased in the right infraaxillary and the subscapular area, which suggests clearly here that probably there is an increased fluid in the lung in the right lower zone, which has led to increased vocal fremitus in this case. Also, on percussion, there is woody dull note present, which is characteristic for a consolidation. Also, on auscultation, there are bronchial sounds present, which can occur due to increased fluid collection or a cavity on a collapse, as well as there is vocal resonance increased, whispering pectoralic is present, and egophone is present, which are all suggestive of a increased fluid collection. So based on history and examination, we can now come to a conclusion like that this is probably an infective pathology, as the patient has fever and it is probably due to consolidation. Now, what points are there in favor of consolidation is, one, there is a productive cough of the rusty type. There is non-foul smelling discharge, no association with posture. On examination, vocal fremitus is present, vocal resonance is present, bronchial sounds are present, woody dull note is present, and also there is whispering pectoralic present and egophony present. And these are all highly suggestive of consolidation. And also, as these findings are present on the right side, along with the shortness of breath being present more on lying on the left side, this suggests the patient probably has a right-sided consolidation. And as the rusty brown sputum is present, this is probably due to streptococcal pneumonia. And as there is no cyanosis present, this is less likely to be in type 1 respiratory failure. So this is how we can decode a respiratory system history and examination.